Hi, I'm Leslie Meredith with Breakbulk Events and Media. In the studio here, I have a very interesting gentleman, Ugo.
Yeah, this is perfect.
All right. From his company is called Shone. Very high tech, very cutting edge technology, and he's just presented here at Breakbulk Americas some of the things that his company is involved with. So, let us know what that is.
Yeah, so we're basically a Silicon Valley-based startup that was founded about a year ago. So the founding team was from the engineering side. We're working on self-driving car, and I guess we realized that autonomy is inevitable, and it's going to happen to cargo ship as well. But we did not agree with the vision that was shared by Rolls-Royce and Kongsberg regarding the fact that autonomy was going to happen through new unmanned autonomous cargo ship. We believe it's going to happen progressively on existing ships and first empower the crew, and so that's what we're working on right now.
So it's kind of a slower transition or an easier transition to involve the crew first,
yeah.
But the end goal is still an autonomous ship?
Yeah, I guess, so that's basically it. I guess the problem in the industry is that people do not make the difference between autonomous and unmanned. And in my mind, autonomous doesn't mean unmanned. And we believe that autonomy is going to happen, it's going to have a lot of benefits, and it's going to happen first in redundancy of the crew on existing vessels. And I think that's a realistic approach, and I think that's the way it's going to happen.
Right, so what you're saying is it's not going to be a crewless vessel?
No.
Ever?
I mean, probably in the future you're going to have new vessels that are going to be unmanned, but the lifetime of a ship is 20 years, so if you wait for that to happen, and if you wait for, having a binary street from today having 25
yes.
people to zero tomorrow, it's never going to happen this way. It's going to happen on existing vessel first because they're already on the sea, and maybe the job of the seafarer is going to completely change, and you're going to require less people that are going to only work on high value tasks, and you're going to go from a crew of 25 people to 15 on existing ships, but you're still going to have a bottleneck that's mainly due to the hardware of the existing ships. So if you want to go through the next level, then you'll need new unmanned vessel, but if you want to develop those, you need to develop the first technology blocks that you can develop on existing vessels.
So that's so interesting. So what are the first steps?
So I guess the first step is, as any autonomous vehicle, you need to first understand what's the environment surrounding the vehicle. And so that's what we're mainly working right now, which we call situational awareness. Mm-hmm. So it's basically taking the information of existing sensors on board of a ship, adding additional sensors, and understanding, having a really refined understanding of the environment surrounding the ship. Based on this understanding, we can understand the context and bring the relevant information to the crew in order to take an informed decision and even recommend decision to the crew.
So it's what we're talking about is a form of artificial intelligence.
Yeah, totally. I mean, all the technology behind it, I mean, machine learning, computer vision, we're expert in it as we're working on self-driving car before and like those topics.
Yes.
And I think that's not necessarily an expertise that's already present in the shipping industry. There is really, kind of two wars between Silicon Valley, where the technology happens, and the maritime industry, which in my mind has been left behind for too long.
All right. So, do you have any of your software on ships now?
Yeah, so we're mainly working, we're working with different companies, but we're mainly working with CMS CGM, so working to onboard the crew on some of their 14,000 TEUs vessel. We're actually integrated on ships and developing the technology.
Wow, so this is not in the future, this is now.
This is happening now.
That is so exciting. Well, I want to thank you for sharing this with us. It's really a cool thing that's going on.
Yeah, thank you.
All right.
Bye.